Let's see what would happen if the order of rotation and scaling were reversed. That is, first we'd rotate and then we'd scale our sphere. For our clock exercise, the result would look like this. The rotation seems to have had no effect. Think about what the order of operations actually does to the object. First we rotate the sphere. This has little effect on what we see on the screen. A sphere looks pretty much the same from any angle. So by doing the rotation first, we've essentially lost its effect. Stretching the sphere afterwards gives us the shape we want, but the rotation's already been done. At this point, I want to show you a great program for experimentation, the 3JS Interactive Scene Editor. See the additional course materials for a link to this program. To start, let's add a sphere to the scene. It comes in black as there's really no light in the scene, so let's add a directional light, put it over here, and select our sphere. We can move our sphere around, and you can see the change of position over here. You can also rotate it, and obviously it doesn't look very different because it's a sphere, but you can also non-uniformly scale it. So here we've scaled it a bit, and I can rotate it, and you can see the effect. Give this program a try. It's really excellent for figuring out how rotations, scales, and positions work together.